Good afternoon, class. This is your history and civics class, and today we'll continue with the topic Zilla Parishad. This is your first chapter in civics, the rural and local self-government. We have studied till the functions of block samiti. Now we'll begin with our next topic, that is Zilla Parishad. The Zilla Parishad is the highest institution of the Panchayati Raj in India. The Zilla Parishad coordinates the activities of block samitis in the whole district. What is the Zilla Parishad is known as the highest institution of the Panchayati Raj in India, okay? And then it coordinates the activities of the block samitis, that which means block samiti and Zilla Parishad work in coordination. It is composed of chairman of all block samitis in a district, member of Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha from the district, members of Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad from the districts, representative of SC, ST and women. The Zilla Parishad elects a president and a vice president from among it members. Okay, so what is the composition of Zilla Parishad, or what all are the components of Zilla Parishad? The Zilla Parishad is composed of chairman of all blocks in a district. All the block samiti's chairman are the one of the composition of Zilla Parishad. Then the members of Lok Sabha and Raj Sabha, members of Vidhan Sabha and Vidhan Parishad, representative of SC, ST and women. SC is scheduled caste and ST is scheduled tribe. The Zilla Parishad elects a president and a vice president from among its members. Okay. Now the functions of the Zilla Parishad. The main function of the Zilla Parishad is to see that village panchayats and block samitis work properly. What is the main function of Zilla Parishad? Its main function is to see that the village panchayat and the block samitis work properly. The Zilla Parishad also has the responsibility of implementing various programs. The Zilla Parishad also prepares and executes development plans for district. Coming on to the sources of income. Like those of block samitis, the source of income of the Zilla Parishads are mainly from taxes and the financial grants from the government. Now, whatever the tax is being collected from the public and the financial grants which is provided by the government, that is the basic source of income for the Zilla Parishad. Okay. Besides, the Zilla Parishad also gets income from the property owned by it. Whatever property is being owned by the Zilla Parishad, the Zilla Parishad used to get some of the income from that also. Okay. Moving on to the achievements of the Panchayati Raj. The Panchayati Raj has brought political awareness among rural people. They elect and select the Panchayat members and also take part in decision making. The Panchayati Raj has brought a political awareness. What did Panchayati Raj bring? What was the big achievement for the Panchayati Raj? The big achievement for the Panchayati Raj was that it brought a political awareness, which means people became aware of all the political parties and what all were the political leaders, and people became politically aware. Okay, the rural people became politically aware and they used to elect and select the panchayat members and also take part in decision making. Okay, the Panchayati Raj improved the condition of the villages through welfare activities. Very many welfare activities were organized in order to improve the condition of the villages. Okay, panchayats have been able to draw the attention of the government officials to their problem. With the help of the panchayats, the villagers were able to draw attention towards the problems of the government officials. Okay, the state government and the Panchayati Raj. The Constitution of India has strengthened the village panchayats by giving them more powers. It directs that regular elections to the panchayats should be held every 5 years. For this purpose, State Election Commission has been formed. The government gives financial grants to the Panchayati Raj system. 33% of seats in panchayats are reserved for women. The Constitution of India has strengthened the power of the village panchayats. The village panchayats has got a special kind of power or special strength which is provided by the Constitution of India to them, and it directs that regular elections of the panchayats because of the in the constitution also it is stated that on the regular basis the panchayat election should be held, which is supposed to be held every 5 years. Okay, for this purpose state election commission has been formed. State election commission has been formed. Why has it been formed? It has been formed in order to see that every after every 5 years there should be an election for the panchayats. Okay, the government official grant to the panchayati raj system, 33% of seats in the panchayat also, 33%, how much percentage? 33% of seat is reserved for the women. 33% of seat is women is reserved for the women in the panchayati raj. The state government keeps a district the state government keeps a strict watch on the working of the panchayati raj institution. Who keeps a strict watch? The state government keeps a strict watch on the panchayati raj institution. The collector, district magistrate or the deputy commissioner represents the state government at the district level. Who represent the government at the district level? The collector or the district magistrate or the deputy commissioner. Okay, they represent the state government at the district level. He coordinates the work of the government officer to the district and the panchayati raj. The block development officer does the same work at the block level. What does the collector or the district magistrate do? They represent the state government at the district level and coordinate with the government officers of the district and the panchayati raj, and same is the work of the block developmental officer at the block level. Okay, so this is the end of the chapter. We have finished the reading and the explanation of this lesson, which is the first chapter of your civics, the rural local self-government. Okay, thank you class, that's all for today. Thank you class.